Cheers. I am so excited to be announcing that I started a YouTube channel and that this is my first video. Some of you may already know me from my beauty Instagram page, Sweet as a Cup Katie, where I post product pictures, flat lays, and micro reviews of different skincare and beauty products. I also have a beauty and lifestyle blog at cupkatie.com, which I will be linking below in the description box, as well as the eye up here, if I can figure out the eye button. I'm by no means a professional makeup artist, but I do have a passion for makeup and skincare that I would love to share with you. So if this sounds like something you would be interested in, and I know that it is, subscribe, hit the bell, come chat with me over on Instagram. Now, let's get into the video. By now, you've already seen the introduction to my channel, so this is gonna be pretty short. Today's video is going to be a casual get ready with me where I talk a little bit more about myself and where I plan on going with my channel. I'm not going to do a huge focus on the products that I'm using. I will list them down below in case you see something that catches your eye. I've already prepped my skin, applied sunscreen, and filled in my eyebrows. I like to do my eyebrows when I'm waiting for my sunscreen to set. Otherwise, the products all pill. I'm going for a pretty natural, lightish look today since I have errands to run. I don't want to spend hours working on my makeup. There are days that definitely is something I like to do, but today is not that kind of day. Did you pick up the Super Sponge when it was available for pre-order? I've really been enjoying it. I've never been a big fan of the Beauty Blender. I don't know why. It's always been so hyped up, and I feel like I'm the only person in the world who doesn't like using it. I really like the silicone side where you can just glide the product on and you don't lose the coverage or any product. When I'm going for a light natural look, I like to apply a lot of products underneath the foundation and then go in with a lighter coverage foundation. I find that it keeps things looking a lot more natural. And then using the Super Sponge again on the silicone side and just pressing that into the skin. For a little over a year, I've been wanting to start a channel, but I kept finding excuses or reasons to put it off. There was always something that stopped me from going after it. But now I don't have any excuses since my fiance, our daughter, and I moved into our new condo. We've been working on getting together a filming space, and everything is finally set up, and I kept pushing it off because everything had to be perfect. But now we just have to start filming and uploading and making changes as necessary. So you'll see through upcoming videos that different lighting or maybe placements have changed while we perfect what we're trying to do to make my videos more enjoyable for you. So if you notice anything or if you want any changes or if you see something that you think we can improve, definitely let me know down below. I was so worried if I uploaded something and it wasn't perfect that I would fail right off the bat. I was too nervous to even start. And so decided I kind of just have to go with it, and I can always improve, I can always make something better, and I can always try again. And I know one thing that I'm hoping to change in upcoming videos is getting a new lens for my camera. I'm filming off of a Nikon D5100, and let me tell you, I do not suggest starting with a Nikon. If you're planning on making a video, if you're planning on doing a YouTube or whatever it is, don't get a Nikon. But I don't have the money to just buy a brand new DSLR camera, so I have to use the one that I have. If I could change one thing, if I could go back and change one thing, I would definitely start by using a Canon DSLR. What kind of videos are you interested in? I have some uploads planned for the rest of August, but I'm happy to rearrange the schedule if there's something that you would like to see. If there's a product coming out that you're interested in, if there's an old product that you're interested in that you'd like to see it reviewed on, I don't mind. Alex might mind because it comes out of his wallet, but I don't mind spending his money to review something for you. I love product reviews. I love try-ons. I love hauls. I am not a professional makeup artist, so tutorials maybe are something that I have to work on getting comfortable with doing. If my skin type is normal leaning dry, I don't have a huge problem with breakouts. When I do, they're typically around my chin and underneath the jawline. There are some products that have ingredients that I do tend to have a reaction to. I'm a really big fan of the wet skin look, especially because my skin is so dry, it tends to suck up any kind of hydration that I throw at it. I keep a facial mist around at all times. The one I'm currently loving is the Sephora brand coconut mist. I just bought another one because I'm almost out. I usually keep it in the fridge. It's been so nice to have cooled for the summer. The foundation that I put on while I was getting ready is the BareMinerals Complexion Rescue Hydrating Foundation Stick. Anyways, that one I have in the lightest shade, Opal, which I actually think is a pretty good shade match. I live in a suburb of Chicago. I've lived around Chicago my whole life, pretty much. I did move to Wisconsin to go to college. I graduated from the University of Wisconsin Stevens Point in 2009 with a Bachelor of Science in Political Science and Public Administration Policy Analysis. I had originally intended to go to law school, but you know how life kind of gets in the way sometimes, and I ended up working a couple of jobs that I really didn't like, and I decided if I was going to spend the rest of my life working, it might as well be something that I enjoy doing. Ended up going to culinary school, took a job down in Australia for a year, and I worked as a pastry chef in Perth, Australia. So that was a very exciting time in my life, and when I came home from Australia, I began working as a cake decorator, and ultimately that's how I met Alex. And we've been together for just about 3 years, just under 3 years. I started getting into makeup late in high school. I was never really interested in makeup in my early teens. It was my late teens, early 20s, I suppose, that I really became interested. And even then, I was more interested in special effects makeup. I don't remember if I mentioned that I'm 31, almost 32. This video is going to be posted just before my birthday. I'm not really interested in keeping track of birthdays anymore. I have a hard time remembering. It took me a while to remember I was even going to be 32 this year. It's kind of hard to just sit here and talk about myself. I don't wear false lashes. I almost never wear eyeliner. If I'm doing any kind of eyeliner look, I use eyeshadow most of the time. When I do wear eyeliner, my favorite eyeliner has been the Always Sharp Kohl pencil from Smashbox in the shade Raven, which is the black shade. When I was working in Australia, and even when I was in culinary school and just, you know, working in the kitchen, you sweat a lot. Something that worked really well was that eyeliner for years. It was my holy grail, always reached for, never sweated off, never melted off, never cried off, whereas a lot of other products you can't really say the same thing for. I just ran out of mine. Actually, I think it took me about 2 years to use up. That's how little I wear eyeliner, I guess is where I'm going with that. I don't wear hair extensions, so when my hair's out, anything you see is my real hair, which is curly and unmanageable. So that is definitely something I need to work on as the channel grows, because I cannot do my own hair. I can straighten it. I can somewhat curl it. It occasionally holds a curl with a lot of work. My natural curly hairstyle is pretty flat. It just falls. There's no real volume to it. After I had the baby, all my hair fell out, and I had these bald patches all over my head, and my hairline was tragic. I had tried so many products to re-stimulate hair growth because the bald patches and the hairline were so embarrassing for me, even though I know that it was a normal thing, and anyone that's gone through having a baby has gone through the same process. I tried all sorts of, you know, fullness shampoos, Living Proof, Bumble and Bumble. I tried taking, you know, vitamins, supplements. You know, finally the hair growth is pretty normalized. It doesn't seem as thick as it was. Years ago I used to have hair extensions. I think I actually have like a permanent no growth spot because of where I used to wear my hair extensions so much. I used to sleep in them, which I know you're not supposed to do, but when you're out, what are you gonna do? Take out your hair? I guess that's it for the eye look. I probably should have sprayed my face with my setting spray before I went in with the mascara, but I suppose this is just what we're gonna do. Like I said before, I like the dewy skin look, and my face definitely looks wet. Right now, I've been really enjoying watching myself on the monitor because it's exactly how I like my skin to look. And I'm more excited to see how it's going to go after I put the spray on, because I bet it's going to be even wetter. And you're going to be watching this going, Katie, your skin is wet. It's wet. It's fine where it is. Don't add the spray. But guess what? I wasn't sure what shade of lipstick I wanted to wear, so I am wearing the shade In Love with Olivia from the new Hot Lips 2 collection from Charlotte Tilbury. I was going for a cute down look, but it is way too hot here in Chicago to do anything with my hair down. It looks like a disaster. So we're going with a messy top bun, and that's just how we're going to run errands today. I hope that you enjoyed getting ready with me. Let me know down in the comments what you want to see more of. I'm so excited to be here on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching my first video. You can catch me most often on Instagram. Don't miss an upload. Subscribe and hit the bell so you're notified on Sundays and Wednesdays when I upload. Thank you for being here. I'll catch you on Wednesday with my next video on how I do my eyebrows.